Today we're going to be making blueberry streusel muffins without Mrs. Sour.
Hey, I don't think you're ready for this, G. All right, we're actually going to be making them a little bit more nutritious because we're going to be incorporating whole wheat flour into them. So this is part of our new nutrition unit. I'm doing a demo instead of doing it live, but you will get a taste of the muffins at some point this week. And it's also preparation for our cooking unit. So Jake's gonna help me out because students love to see Jake in the videos with Mrs. Sour, right? Okay, so we have all our equipment out, we have all ingredients out, and we're ready to roll. So the first ingredient is 1 cup of milk. Do you wanna measure that?
Sure.
Okay, so milk is gonna be measured in a liquid measuring cup, and you always measure it at eye level, and do you know what kind of a surface?
Flat.
Flat surface. So we're going to use our counter. So I'm going to open that up and see, Jake. So this is one of our last videos, or our newest videos, where Jake is now 10. And we started the videos when he was about 6. And now he doesn't even need a step stool. So we're good. He can reach the counter and everything. So 1 cup is there. So you always have to bend down. Eye level on a flat surface. So while Jake does that, I'm gonna measure the vegetable oil, which is also a liquid. Why are you gonna do it over there? You're not gonna go over it because that's why liquid measuring cup has a pouring spout. That's all right, hold it. You're good. So the milk is brand new. We're also using 1% milk rather than whole milk to make it nutritious too. So Jake is measuring it, but he needs to get down and bend down while he does it because he has to do it at eye level on a flat surface. And are you on the line?
Yeah.
So he's exactly on the line. So what a professional he is, but I think he had a really good teacher. Where is the cap though? So we've lost the cap, but I put the cap over there. We're gonna put a green over there. So what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna measure a quarter of a cup of vegetable oil, and he's gonna help me tell me where the line is because I can't see it. Is that the line?
Where is it?
Is it a 1/4? That's a half, and that's a quarter.
A little bit more.
Tad.
Right there.
Okay. So again, 2 liquid measuring cups you would need, or you would have to measure one, then the other one. And I'm gonna put the ingredients over to the side. The next ingredient is 1/2 teaspoon of vanilla. So this comes out really, really quick. Whoops, I put the other container. So I don't have custard bowls at home. I forgot to bring them from school. It's a Sunday morning here, and Jake is being asked to help me with the video. It's actually part of his chores this week because he didn't do many of his chores, right, Jake?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so he's gonna measure 1/2 teaspoon. So he's getting paid now for doing videos, and I don't. Okay, 1/2 teaspoon, is that 1/2?
That's 1 teaspoon.
So again, Jake's helping my eyes out. 1/2?
1/2.
Okay, so he's gonna know that he's gonna go really, really slowly because this is gonna pour out quickly and he doesn't wanna go over it. So while Jake does that, you're gonna do it over the bowl just in case you get a little bit too much. And I'm going to crack my egg.
A little bit too much.
So we got a little bit, hold up. He got a little bit too much. So you're gonna hold that steady. I'm gonna pour this in the sink. I'm going to put my egg shell there.
It's very hard.
It's okay, you did it.
Should I dump it?
You're going to dump it. So I'm going to put the egg to the side. He's just going to put this on here because Tommy likes things neat. And so does he. And the vanilla is done too.
Now we need
how much flour, Jake? All-purpose flour. 1 1/2. So Jake knows that we should have a spoon, and Mommy, Mrs. Sour, doesn't have that. 1 1/2. I already did the egg. You didn't see me?
No.
Can you grab a large spoon out of the drawer? So apparently I didn't have all my equipment out. And of course, we've washed our hands, put our hair up. That's an awful large spoon, but that'll work.
Well, you said the large spoon.
That'll work.
Okay, good.
So he knows because he's done this before. He's had the blueberries in it. He's going to lightly spoon and level off our flour. So he has a big piece of wax paper to do it over. And then he's going to put the measured flour over here. So you're going to grab the spoon. You're going to lightly spoon it. And then he's going to level it off with a leveler. right? And if it gets all over the place, it gets all over the place. That's why we're using the wax paper. So while he does that, I'm gonna have to grab another spoon and I'm gonna do the same thing with the whole wheat flour. So again, this is what's making the recipe a little bit healthier using the whole wheat flour. Because whole wheat flour has more what in it, Jake? Hold up, because I have to teach you something what you're doing.
Yep.
Has more what in it? Starts with an F.
Fiber.
Fiber in it, okay? And that's what we talked about during nutrition. So what I noticed is Jake was taking the spoon and packing it down. You never pack flour down. So what he should be doing, and he should know this from other recipes, he heaps it over, and then when you use a leveler, you use it like that. So we have bigger levelers, so if using a bigger leveler is easier,
yeah,
that's what you can do. Okay, so as I was saying, I'm going to be measuring, I made this font extremely small, a half cup of whole wheat flour, right? So I'm gonna grab a half. Now I've tried this recipe, going equal amounts of whole wheat and the white flour, and was not as good. So the whole wheat flour makes it nutritious. It has a more of a nutty flavor. And actually the white flour that most of us use in recipes is not very healthy for us. The whole wheat is, because it comes from the whole wheat or the whole grain. So you
is that good?
So yeah, you have to heat it over. And then you make it like this, you're good. And now you're gonna put it over there. So Jake's playing with it a little too much.
No, I thought it had to be even.
Well, it was, but you were dipping the leveler in it. So now you need a half cup. Don't look at me like that, but I need the half cup. So Jake knows by now, he's just gonna measure the quarter cup two times. So now I forgot what I was saying about the whole wheat flour, but I think I was saying that the white flour gets stripped of all of its, you're gonna continue, of all of its good stuff to make it white. So when you can use whole wheat flour, use whole wheat flour, but you need a little bit more liquid in the recipe because it does dry it out a little bit too. So you have a huge spoon there. So what you can be doing is filling it like that and then leveling it off.
Dumping.
So I'm gonna do the same thing. You're gonna put it with the other measured stuff, but get it on the wax paper because it's falling off. So I'm gonna do it over the container because right now I don't have another piece of wax paper to put it on. So when we do start the cooking unit, you should have two pieces of wax paper, one to level over like Jake's doing, and then another large piece, if it's a large amount to measure, to put the measured ingredients on. So I'm gonna level off and I'm gonna place mine here. So Jake knows all that extra flour now is gonna go back into the container, so hold up. So we're gonna get it so it's nice and easy. I'm gonna bring it like this. Whoop. Gonna pick it up and pop it all right back in there. And then he's gonna put the flour to the side. Just keep the cover off because we're gonna need that for something with the blueberries that's gonna help us. So we have what ingredients? So we did the flour, we did the whole wheat flour. What's next, Jake?
Whole wheat flour, sugar.
Okay, so now we're gonna measure the sugar that I have in that container. So Jake's gonna grab that container. Now the sugar you can spoon or you can just pour it. So how much sugar, Jake?
1/3.
1/3 of a cup. So we're gonna grab the 1/3 cup. So you could either pour it. And I have two pieces of wax paper. I said pour it, you can scoop it or you can pour it, but pouring is probably gonna be easier because it's gonna be hard to get that. So again, you have this big piece of wax paper, right? And then if there's any chunks, you'll just grab the spoon and just go like that. Once it's all done, you could do it once it's measured onto here. I'm gonna be measuring the baking powder. So baking powder is called a leavening agent. So he knew enough, he heaped it over, and then he has to remember to level it off with a
leveler.
And then he's gonna place the measured amount on the other piece of wax paper. Then he knows he's going to take the extra sugar and he's going to put it back in the container.
Which is where?
The one, there's our timer just went off for our oven because our oven has been preheated. And I need 1 tablespoon of the baking powder. So again, like I said, it's a leavening agent. It's what's going to make these muffins rise. So I'm going to take my big tablespoon. There's actually a leveler on the container. And scrape it off, If you don't use the baking powder, these pancakes are not going to rise. Maybe put that. The muffins are not going to rise. So you could just put the cap on. So we have salt next. Jake's going to grab the container of salt. Then I'm going to talk about the blueberries. So he's going to measure a small amount, which is a half teaspoon. So instead of using this large piece of wax paper, we're going to cut it in half. He's going to level off. So let me just get this little... You're going to go slowly. It doesn't matter with the salt, but overflows. We're just going to throw that in the garbage, right? And I'm going to talk about the blueberries. So I already have the blueberries. I've rinsed them. These are some enormous blueberries that they had at Stop and Shop. Look at the size of that blueberry. Yep, you're always going to level off. Yeah. Whoops, did I give you a piece of wax paper? Okay, and then you're going to put the measured stuff there. So blueberries, there's a little trick. If we just put these blueberries in the batter, they're going to all sink to the bottom. Same like with pancakes. So there's a little trick to that. That's why we kept the cover off of the flour. You can throw it out, but don't get it all over the floor while you do it. So I'm going to sprinkle flour all over the blueberries, and that's going to help when we put it in the bowl that won't all sink to the bottom. Can you put that back over there? And then I'm just going to rinse my hand off, and then we're going to start with the directions. So what was the first direction that I think we already did, Jake?
Preheat oven to 400 degrees.
Okay, our oven is preheated. What's our next? What's our next?
Measure out all ingredients.
We've done that. Mm-hmm. What is three?
Beat milk, oil, vanilla, and egg in a large bowl using a wire whisk.
Okay, so you want to do that?
Sure.
So you're going to beat your milk?
Oh, in order.
Well, it doesn't matter for this. Milk, go slowly. So we're not making this recipe in our cooking unit. I just do this during the nutrition just to get you ready for cooking and just show you a healthy recipe, because I'm gonna be honest, all the recipes we make, is that supposed to go in there?
No.
Okay, so why would you be putting it in there?
I didn't.
Just go stop that, please. So Jake's getting a FaceTime video right now that he's just going to stop. So that's a big mistake that students usually do in school. They're not reading their directions.
It didn't go in there.
He just read it. That's fine. And he caught himself. So milk, oil. Then he's going to put the vanilla and the egg, and he's going to whisk it.
Don't do that, kids.
But they're not going to be making this. They can make this at home, though, if they do like the blueberry streusel muffins. So some people may not like blueberries. Again, you could probably incorporate another vegetable in there. That's just because the oil with the milk.
This?
Vanilla, is that what it says? And egg. So that's what it said. That's what you read, right? Reread it.
Vanilla.
So while he's doing that, I'm going to do what it says in a medium bowl. It says combine the flour, the sugar, the baking powder, and the salt.
Egg.
And then Jake's going to whisk that. So I'm going to give him that small whisk. Did I give it to you?
Yeah.
I'm basically taking all the other dry ingredients. Flour. Holy flour. So we're hoping that Mr. Sour Daddy doesn't show up while we're doing the video. He likes to come in and ruin it sometimes and make the kids laugh too. So Jake's got to do is he's got to use his muscles a little bit more and break that egg up, but without it getting all over the place. So I do see that there's some chunks in the sugar, so I'm going to fix that. So I'm going to add my sugar, and mine just says to combine. So that just means to do what, Jake? If mine says to combine, what does that mean? What am I going to do?
Put it all in the same bowl.
Right, but what am I going to do? How do I combine it? With my finger?
No.
What can I use?
A whisk, if you
wanted. A whisk? Well, that's going to be all wet. So what would I use over here to stir it? Tell me. You don't have to walk over. What would I use over here to stir it?
This wooden spoon.
Okay, I thought I taught him more than this. He's done banana bread videos.
So I forgot.
He's done bubble pizza.
I forgot.
Okay, I guess he can forget. Well, next year, Jake will be taking Family and Consumer Science. Let's hope he has a great
skill.
Such a good teacher like I am to my students, right?
Mm-hmm. Uh-huh. I don't know what goes on in that classroom.
Good things go on.
Do you give them Starburst?
Well, I haven't been eating Starburst, so I can't give them junk food while we're talking about nutrition. Okay, so we're good to to go. In a medium bowl, Jake did what he had to. I did what I had to. It says using a wooden spoon or a rubber scraper. Thank you, because he knows I can't see. So now what we're going to do, it says, I'm going to add that using a wooden spoon or rubber scraper, stir just until flour. So we're going to make a little well in this. Actually, no, this is going in here. In a medium bowl, fine flour, add all to the large bowl. At this point, so remember with the banana bread, this is where you do not want to overmix. So overmixing can cause tunnels in your muffins and can make the end product tough. So Jake knows from other recipes that we've prepared that he's very slowly, he's going to stir this and incorporate it using a rubber scraper. So he's going to keep going like this,
and get the stuff off,
turning
the wall.
It out, getting it all off the walls very slowly. You're not going to take, okay, and mix it like that. And then eventually, we're going to add the blueberries. So you're going to do what you call, it's called folding in. So just watch, Mommy. This is sour. So you're going to take it in the middle and lift it. As I do that, you can see I can scrape around the side of the bowl. Keep going. So I was going to make mini muffins, and then I realized that with these huge blueberries, it's just going to be all blueberry in the smaller pans that I told students I was going to do. So what I am going to do is I'm just going to make regular size muffins. It only makes 12. I have 3 classes, and I have some pretty big classes, and I have one big class, yep. So I'm going to have to make this recipe 3 to 4 times, either today or I'm going to do it a couple days in school this week. So he shouldn't be really stirring it, okay? But he should have chunks. You're taking it in the middle and just going like that.
You don't want chunks?
You want some chunks. Okay, so we're going to say it still needs some mixing, but we have to get the blueberries in. So I'm going to pour the blueberries in. And then you're going to very carefully, again, stir it more. This is where you really have to be careful because, right, he knows that he's not going to crush them. So this has a streusel topping on top, which doesn't make it that healthy. But
what is that?
It's a streusel topping. It's really good. It kind of defeats the purpose of me making this.
Healthy.
But it's going to be delicious. It's going to make you like this better. So what it is, I've already prepared it. It is butter, brown sugar, flour, and cinnamon, okay? And it's gonna make it really tasty on top. All right, so we're gonna need 2 spoons the same size. I'm probably gonna do this part, and then you're going to...
How's this?
That's good. Okay, so I'm just gonna check to see if Jake did his job. I'm gonna kinda lift it, make sure there's no dry stuff on the bottom, and he looks good. So we're gonna leave the rubber scraper out. So when we do cook, I always say leave the rubber scraper and the wooden spoon out to the end because you may need it. So I'm now gonna take a nice big heaping spoonful.
You want the big spoon?
You know what, give me the bigger spoon.
2?
Sometimes I use a measuring cup here too.
2 or 1?
2. You always need 2 spoons, and I'll show you why. They're fine. That's fine.
They're not the same size.
That's fine, they're almost the same. So we're gonna go about halfway. Seems a little watery. I think it's got a little on that something.
What? I didn't do it.
We're gonna try to get nice 1 big heaping spoonful in each. Now you could use like a measuring cup to do this too, but you see that I'm using the 1 spoon. It's kind of like when you do drop cookies. Seems to be a lot of big blueberries in here, so everybody should be getting,
a blueberry
in each.
I think that
makes your problem. So he's telling me that more should go in somewhere, so I'm going to make sure I do get 12 muffins, probably not the best way, so kids can't see what I'm doing.
One.
All right, but that's 1 on top.
Oh, might be a few on the bottom.
So, what did I just do with that streusel topping? Can you grab that? I don't know if that's the way you should grab them. So we're going to wait 1 second.
Can I smell it?
You know what? I just want to try something and see if this would work better.
Yeah, exactly.
It does. Oh, these blueberries are big. See, I hope my students like blueberries because it's going to mostly be blueberries.
Blueberry.
Maybe next time I'm going to go a little bit easier on the blueberries and not put a cup. Maybe I'll go like 3/4 or something.
Did I do good?
You did good. You should. You've been doing it for a few years now, right? Mm-hmm. That's got a lot of blueberries. I don't think I'm going to put any more blueberries in any of these. So we went about 2/3 to 3/4. That needs more, right?
Mm-hmm. And that one.
And then we're going to put the streusel topping. How many minutes are we at, Jake? About 20-something?
20 minutes, 24 seconds.
Because I'm sure this is not what the kids want to do all period, is watch us. I'm sure they do it a lot of work. Right? Just like you getting out of work? Oh, yeah, this year. Mm. You really don't get out of work. Okay, I don't know. Now, do we have to redo the whole video? Yeah, they've heard about that, but... Mr. Nutter, he may be watching this video. Whoops, maybe we shouldn't have said that either. Okay, here we go. Now, we're going to take the streusel topping, and we're going to sprinkle it like that.
Me?
Both of us are going to get our hands in here. You know what? Let's put some in this bowl. That way we can both get to it. All right, so now we're going to take, yep, just take it. You can get it all over the counter. I don't want it all over my floor, though. Else who's going to be sweeping it?
Me! Okay. Am I putting enough?
Yeah. Again, this is what's making it unhealthy. So we'll know right away if Jake overmixed the muffins without even eating any. Because if you have a peaked top like this, that
like
means you overmixed. Right, like a peaked top mountain. Right? It should have a nice golden round top. So I think we're good on the streusel. Okay, what we're gonna do is we're gonna get what for our hands to put this in the oven. What should we use to protect? We're gonna get oven mitts and we're gonna put them in the oven for anywhere from 24, oh, that's for the smaller muffin. So I'm gonna say 18 to 24 minutes. So I'm gonna put it for 18 and then we're gonna check it from there and then we'll show you what they look like and see if we got peaks or not. So Jake's gonna go over and hit the stop for right now button. And then we're going to come back and show you when our blueberry streusel muffins are done.
Well, we got the muffins out of the oven. And they look pretty rounded.
They look pretty rounded. I think Jake did a good job. The blueberries are bursting and that streusel topping looks delicious. So now we're going to let them cool. And I hope that Jake is going to try a blueberry muffin. Are you going to try one, Jake?
No, thank you.
Yeah, Picky Jake again. So say welcome. Thank you for watching our video.
Thank you for watching our video.
And everybody,
it has been a pleasure.
And everybody will get a taste. I am on my 4th batch of muffins for today. Jake helped with how many?
1.
Okay. Say thank you for watching.
Thank
we'll see
you
again
for watching.
Soon.
It has been a pleasure. See you soon. See you in the next video. Mrs. Sauer is great.
No, what am I on YouTube? They could pull me up and subscribe to
Naomi Sauer.